Like Christian said, I'm Florian Sovade. I'm working at CrossCan in Witten currently. I'm studying in Dortmund and I do C++ since about 5 years, and I'm member of the PHP User Group Dortmund, which organizes this subconference since about 4 years, and this is the main reason why I make this talk. And you can find me on Twitter also. About this talk, if you want to write a PHP extension, the PHP core provides a C API, mostly a C preprocessor API, but to develop these extensions. And this C API can be used from C++, because C++ is mainly a superset of C. And so basically, we are done here. If you want to write a PHP extension with C++, just use the C API. The problem is that the C API is a C API, and that in C++ we have better features. And so what I try to show is that this API can be wrapped in C++. And by doing this, we get all the great C++ features, like objects, exceptions, templates, and so on. And we can use the advanced C++ techniques, which aren't available in C, like RAI and template metaprogramming. And what I try to show in this talk is a proof of concept that such a wrapper library can be built, and how it could look. All my code is C++ 11, which is the new C++ standard, because it provides great features that I want to use. But the code I show is incomplete and not tested, so I don't show how you can develop good extensions with C++, but how you can develop a wrapper for the C API with C++. First of all, I'll shortly cover the C API and show how you traditionally write PHP extensions. And then I'll show how this can be wrapped in C++. First, I'll show how you can register functions, how you can pass the parameters passed by from PHP to your C function, how you can define functions, and I'll shortly cover the Z value. When you write PHP extensions with a C API, first of all, you have a C function for every of your PHP functions, basically. And for every function you register, you also have to provide argument information, which basically describe what parameters your function takes. And they are mainly used for reflection, I think. You have a function table, which contains a list of every function and some information about every function. And you have a module entry, which contains basic information about your extension, like the name or the version. And you have a get module function, which is used by PHP to retrieve the module entry, and which is needed to load your extension, basically. So I'll try to show in several ways how you basically can build this function as a PHP extension. I think it's not really great, but I hope it'll show the techniques required. And the first step, if you use the C API, is to define your function. That's done with this send function macro. The from lines 3 to line 9, you to line 11, you do the argument parsing. So the function takes a string and a boolean. So a string in PHP basically consists of the char pointer, which is the data of your string, and the length. So you are binary safe. And you call this send pass parameters, pass some some information about the number of arguments, and then you give it a string describing what parameters you expect. It contains one char for every parameter, so you say this basically says it expects a string and a boolean, and then you pass the pointers to the where the data should be stored. And this function can fail if the programmer didn't provide the right arguments. But if it succeeds, then you basically can access the name data, name length, and flag, and it contains the data the user passed to you. And you can use it. So I check the flag, return null is a macro provided by PHP, like return string. I simply build the string hello world name and return it. The argument info, like I said, contains information about every argument your function takes. You build this argument information. It's basically an array of C structs. You build it using some macros too. And this basically says I want to build the arguments info for my hello world function. The two zeros are if your function returns a reference or if it gets the rest arguments by reference. And the two means that you have two required arguments. So if the flag was optional, then you would write a one. And then you simply list every argument. The zero means that it's by value, not by reference. And then you have a function table, which is an array of C structs too. You also have macros to build those. And you basically say, I have this function hello world, and arginfo hello world are my arguments info, and argument infos I defined before. And last, you have this module entry where you simply say my extension is named hello world. I have the hello world functions. The zeros are function pointers where you can register callbacks which are called every on startup of the PHP, shutdown of PHP, and startup and shutdown of every request and some info callback, and you have a version. And last, you have this get module function, which basically just returns your module info or your module entry. So that's basically the way to define a function in a PHP C extension. So the first thing I'll try to cover is how the registering of the functions can be enhanced. Therefore, I'll wrap the argument information, the function entry, and the module entry in classes. I'll try to unify the information you have to give at one place, because with the C API, the information is cluttered and you have to give the same information at several places. I won't use macros for this API because without macros it's much easier to generate the information from higher level APIs. I try to use speaking API names and less positional arguments, like the zero for this is a reference and this is a value. And but I have to rely on implementation details of PHP, because the API can't be built using using the macros only. This is all wrapped in the API, so the user does not have to rely on implementation details. So first, the example. All but the function could look, you've seen before in the C API, could look like this. So you have this module entry. you first give the name of your module and the version, so hello world version 1.0. And then you basically give a list of all the functions you have. So you have this hello world function. Hello world is the callback, so it's basically a function pointer to the z function. And then you list all the arguments. And last, you can pass some optional stuff, like if you want pass rest by reference, or if you want to return rest by reference, you just write it down like this. First of all, the arginfo struct is really a simple struct which gets the information if the parameter is optional, and then just gets all the parameters which are stored inside the actual send arg info struct. I omitted those here because they are not that important. And the arg info struct ensures that it can be converted to the actual send arg info struct. And of course, you have to access if it's an optional parameter. And you don't construct the arg info structs yourself, but therefore there are construction functions like the one from line 17, value argument, which is used in the example, value argument and optional value argument are used there, which basically gets the name of the argument, and then it knows that it has to set the isReference flag to zero and the optional flag to false, because it's not an optional. And you can write functions like this for value argument, optional value argument, reference argument, and optional reference argument. And last, you have the arginfo sequence, which basically wraps all the arguments of one function. So you get the arg infos in the constructor. It stores it inside the struct, and then it can return the pointer to the arg info, so basically the array of the argument infos, and the size, of course, which is needed by the for the function entry. And to enable the pass rest by reference syntax, this is if the rest arguments should be passed by reference, or if the return value should be a reference, is something stored inside the argument information too. But I wanted to write this information not inside the argument info constructor, which basically just takes the argument infos, but to put it inside the function constructor. So I have to provide a setup for that, which is just this pass rest by reference function you see there. Next, the function entry. This is a wrapper struct too. So you just have this function entry struct, which takes the arguments required to store inside the actual send function entry struct, which is basically the name, the handler, and the argument infos. But I won't take send arg info here, but the arg info sequence class we created before, of course. And last, you have you can pass multiple functions, which are just these pass rest by reference, return by reference, something like this, which simply get called and will set the pass rest by reference flag inside the arg info sequence. And because you properly want to build an extension with multiple functions, we have to provide a function entry sequence too. And by taking an initializer list, which is a C++ 11 feature, which basically just says that you can provide multiple function entries with curly braces, and this ensures that we don't have to write the class name function entry multiple times in front of every single function entry. So this ensures this that this syntax with curly braces works. And the module entry I won't show here because I think it's very straightforward to build the module entry if you have this function entry and function entry sequence already. Okay, the next step I want to cover is actually parsing the arguments. This is the way it's done in the C API. Like I said before, you have to provide the string describing the types of the parameters you expect, and then give pointers to the location the arguments should be stored. The first problem is that the types are duplicated, because first of all we have to give the function the information that it's expecting a string by writing the s in the string, and next by giving it two parameters, the name data and the name length. And the second problem is that no type conversion can be done. So we can't pass a std string or a boolean or whatsoever and expect PHP to convert the character array and the length to a std string. So what I wrote was something like this. So so you define a boolean and a std string, and you call pass arguments. Basically, give it the same parameters like the C function, but you can omit the string describing the types of the arguments, and this is built automatically in, inside the pass arguments function. The way this is done is simply by having this template parameter type, which is partially specialized for every possible argument type. I only show std string here, and it contains a constant describing the actual char which should go into the string. And then the pass arguments function, first of all it has to take the parameters, it just passes on to the send pass arguments function, and then it takes references to all the variables you want to store the parameters in, and it generates the string basically by just concatenating all the parameter codes and appending a zero, so you have a standard C string. The parsing is, the actual parsing is a bit more complex. This is the, first of all, the parameter struct again. It has three more members. First of all, it has a constructor which just takes a reference to the variable the data should be stored in. It stores this reference internally, and once the commit function is called, it just writes the data to the actual variable you want the data stored in. And it has a params function which returns a tuple. It's just the tuple char point point int point is just some struct which has a char point point and an int point star variable. And these are the actual parameters which are then passed to send pass arguments. I provided a helper function do pass, which takes exactly the same arguments as the pass arguments function. Simply builds a tuple of all the parameters, and then just calls send pass parameters with this parameter. So you basically, the call is simply forwarded, and I convert the return type to a boolean. So success means true, and failure means false. And next of all, there is the commit function, because you like in the std string example, you can't simply pass a char pointer and a size pointer from inside the string. So I have this commit function, helper function, to actually write the parameters to the variable the user gave you. And the pass arguments function then simply calls the doPass function, and if it was successful. If it was not successful, it returns false, and if it was successful, then it simply calls the commit function with all the parameters and returns true. The next step is to actually define functions. The abstraction I showed yet are useful on their own, but with this abstraction we can build higher level abstractions, which are, I hope, a bit more useful, and that's what I'll show now. This is what I try to reach. So if you want to define the function mentioned, the hello world function, simply write define function, give it the return type, the function name, and the list of parameters you expect. Boost optional is simply a type which can hold the boost optional set string is basically a type which can hold either a string or nothing. That's required because our function either returns a string or null, and if the optional contains nothing, basically, then we interpret this as the function returning null. If it contains a string, it's the string returned by the function. And we can just access the parameters the user gave us by simply with the names we defined above. So we can simply access the boolean flag and the std string name. And and the macro also generates a function entry, which is just called hello world, like the function, which we then later can use to inside the module entry to register the function to the PHP core. First of all, we need one more helper function, which is simply called return value. This internal function parameters are the parameters which are passed to all the C functions which implement the PHP functions, and it takes the parameter the last parameter just is the type that is should be returned to the user, and this redvals stringle simply means to set the return value, which is one of the internal function parameters, to a string, and it takes three arguments: the char pointer, which is simply the C string function of the std string, the size, and a flag if the string should be copied or if it's it doesn't have to be copied, and since the C string returned by the C string function is owned by the std string, we have to copy the string. And since we have function overloading in C++, we can define the same return value function simply for another type, this time for an boost optional of any type, and the return value function for boost optional simply checks if the optional has any value, then this value is returned using the return value function. And if it doesn't have any value, then redval null, which is another macro provided by PHP, which simply returns null, is used. And this way we can simply write return value and give it any type, and the function will make sure that that the right thing is returned, basically. If you look at this macro, I won't show the implementation of the macro because I think it's not really readable, but I'll show what this macro expands to. And first of all, it expands to an function declaration, hello world implementation, which is the function which is later implemented by the user of the macro. And this function just returns the type given by the user and takes the parameters given by the parameter type is generated by the parameter function template class template, because booleans we want to pass by values, that string we want to pass by reference. So this parameters, that string parameter type expands to constref to std string, the parameter bool parameter type simply expands to bool. Then it generates the function which Thank you. Yeah, we can handle z-values safely because we wrapped it inside a C++ class, which ensures several things for us, like handling the reference counting and make sure we don't make any errors there. And on the other hand, it simplifies the handling with a z-value, because if we have some z-value and we want to say this z-value now becomes false or 17, we can simply write z-value equals false or equals 17, and the assignment operators are used then, and we don't have to use this z-val bool, z-val long macros, which where we have to give the type a second time, because the compiler basically already knows that it's a bool because our variable is a bool, or it knows that it's a long because our compiler knows it's a long. So that way, yeah, it's much easier to deal with the z values from C++, I hope. And that's basically it. Are there any questions to any part of the talk?
Is the source available on GitHub?
The source is not available on GitHub yet, but will be available on GitHub.
Where will I find it?
GitHub.com/RioDerElfte.
Okay, there's the blackboard.
Is there any chalk?
It's more a green one, but yeah.
On the other side, maybe there's a huge
bump. Yes,
Yeah, that's my GitHub page, and I'll put the code presented here there. It basically contains just a
issue somewhere.
It says battery low, yes.
Yeah, so that's
might be.
There you go.
Are there any other questions?
How does the build tool change?
The extension. So yeah, the build tool basically is a standard C extension build tool, which can also build C++ extensions.
Maybe it was because I wasn't listening enough, but I couldn't really see the difference between what was the wrapper part and what is really needed to write my own extension. Is this part of the wrapper.
The stuff needed for to write your own extension is basically the stuff marked with where example is mentioned in the title of the slide. So this is an example of defining a function. And
so that would be all I need to write my own extension, basically.
This would basically be all to write your own extension, which exposes this hello world function. Yes.
Awesome.
Actually, one more thing.
Build tool change. How do I link them together? Anything?
The question was how does the build tool change, and I didn't change the build tool at all. So I just use the PHP IS, is it called like this, executable, which generates the auto tool stuff and then just uses auto tools needed. But this get entry function you still have to provide. I didn't cover it here, but it's two lines of code, I think.
I think there is no PHP core developer in here, so I'll just ask the question. Is the issue the PHP core, or is it writing in C API?
The issue is the PHP core. One can write... part of the issue is, of course, the C language, because I think that C isn't the best language to provide great APIs. I think C++ can do much better, but it can be done much better in C than it was done in PHP. I don't know what the original problem is. I think it's mainly problem of legacy code. I don't know. I am not a core developer. But to expose an API which to 95% consists of macros isn't the best idea if you want to give a good C API from my point of view. And some basic things in the API are done wrong from my point of view, which are done right in mainly any other C library. Like one example is this basic function, which so you give PHP a pointer to this function, and normally in C, if you pass function pointers as parameters to some library, you at least get the possibility to pass some void pointer, which where you can store information, which then is again passed back by the library to your callback function. And PHP doesn't do it. That's the main reason why the define function I've shown has to be a micro and can't be done without it. Any other questions? Okay, then thank you very much for your attention.